dermatology department.
My condition is horrible. The first thing that people see when they look at me is that, because it's in the middle of my face. I can't hide it at all. Like a Cyclops or something. It just makes me feel bad about myself. I have a fatty lump in between my eyes on the bridge of my nose. It's quite large. It's kind of lumpy in some places, and it doesn't look very nice. It first started when I was about 17. I thought it was a little spot or something, and next thing you know, it just started getting bigger and bigger, and then I went to the doctors, and he said there's nothing they can do about it. I hate this thing on my face more than I've hated anything in my entire life. I miss my face. I just miss how I used to look. It just makes me sad. I don't like having it there.
Connor's lump worries me a lot because, obviously, he's not the person he was when he was 17, 18. He was out all the time, enjoying himself, had lots of friends. Now he spends most of his time at home. He just got a bit more into his shell, a bit more depressed. You know, the fun-loving young lad we used to see all the time is just not there anymore.
Are you all ready? You're a funny guy.
It is holding me back from doing what I want to do because I had dreams, I had ambitions. I wanted to get into boxing or open a restaurant or a bar or something like that.
A couple more of them, look.
But I feel like I have no confidence. Can't do any of that because I have this in my face. Dr. Emma is my last hope. Having the lump on my face removed means everything to me.
Hello, I'm here to see Dr. Emma.
I can go get a better job, be myself again. I can finally do everything. I'll live my life.
Hi, Connor.
You all right?
I'm Dr. Emma. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Do you want to come with me? You have very sparkly big diamonds you have in your ears.
Yes, I got them for Christmas.
They're lovely. So, I'm going to guess what you've come in with today. Yeah, is it this?
It might be, yeah.
How long have you had that for?
I've had it for 5 years. It started like this big size of a pea.
It's got to be a good size,
yeah,
hasn't it?
It has, yeah.
It looks to me that you're probably catching it in your field of vision. Do you see it?
Yeah, like I can see it like out of the corner of my eye.
Yeah. And
say if I was to close this eye, I can't see my hand about here.
Whereas most people can see it. Yeah, I can see it here.
Takes
all
me
the
a
way
bit
around there.
Further, yeah. I've even tried to cut it out a couple of times. It's just standard knife. I was just out and obviously didn't go very well. But
no, it never goes very well. Please don't ever do that again.
<it's not>.
You can leave the surgery to me. And what about having this on your face and the impact on you?
Well, I don't really have much of a social life anymore because I don't really go anywhere or do anything.
Because of this?
Yeah. It just makes me very self-conscious. This is my first impression sort of thing. Like, straight away, it's like, boom.
Yeah.
I work with children, mm-hmm. and obviously children, they don't really understand, so you get them sitting there like, what's that pointing at it? And I just don't want that. It does frustrate me.
Yeah. This is kind of really holding you back,
yeah,
isn't
this
it?
This is the epicentre of my negative feelings towards myself.
Yeah. Well, maybe we can squeeze all those negative feelings out.
Hopefully.
Can I get up close? Yeah, yeah. Is that all right?
You're more than welcome.
Right, hold your wee head up for me. OK, so... Oh, yeah. It's definitely a cyst with a baby cyst attached to it. I'm just going to see if this lifts off nice and easily.
I don't think it's attached. It's just
no,
there.
You're right, it's not attached. You've also lost the bit of the contour of the bridge of your nose, so we have to restore that. We have to be a bit careful when it comes to removing this because we also have to take a little bit of the skin away as well.
Not a big lump.
You don't want that.
No.
Definitely not. I just want to make sure that the scar I leave you is the nicest scar that you can have because that's what you're going to remember me by. I think in your case, I'm going to do it up and down. OK, well, this looks like it's going to be a lot of fun to get rid of. You know, this is called an epidermoid cyst. It's a little bit like a small balloon in the skin. The balloon is getting infilled with dead skin cells. What's interesting is that you have a little baby one attached to it as well, and the little baby one is also now starting to fill itself up with those dead skin cells also. And it is something really that we should be able to get rid of for you. Is that okay?
That's a good deal if you ask me. It's going to be a new me.
Come on through with me to the theatre then.
All right, let's go.
Come on in, Connor. This is Moddy.
Nice to meet you.
So just you lie yourself up on here. Okay, if you lift your head up for me a bit. How's that? Is that all right?
That's perfect. Thank you.
So are you excited?
I am, yeah.
The time has come.
The nerves have kicked in now.
You'll be absolutely fine. So I'm just going to pop the anaesthetic in just now, okay? So just start wriggling your fingers. Wriggly jiggly those fingers. Brilliant. Okay, we're good.
It's going to look like a nice little scar.
Would you like to see it now?
I would.
And then the stitch.
Crazy. I can see from both sides now.
Are you happy with that?
It was amazing. I've never imagined it'd look this good. I'd give you all a hug if I could.
Oh, no, I would take a hug if I could. That was brilliant. This was an epidermoid cyst. It had a nice soft wall, which you could see when we applied any pressure to it. It was a little bit tethered down around the base of it, and then we did a couple of fancy stitches so that it can stick right down and recreate this groove that obviously he had completely lost.
It went as well as it could possibly go. I'm ecstatic with the outcome. So I was worried that after the surgery, I was still gonna feel the same way that I did. I knew I would look different, but I don't know if I would feel different about myself. But I was wrong. I looked in the mirror, saw it wasn't there, and I almost cried. I almost cried. A couple of tears nearly came out, but I managed to hold them back. I was very pleased. Dr. Emma's made a massive difference on my life. She's taken out this lump and given me my self-confidence back and made me myself again. So it's been 2 months since I've seen Dr. Emma. She's an amazing surgeon. She's a wizard with a scalpel. Once I took the dressing off, I was so happy with the outcome. I was speechless, like I was blown away. When I look in the mirror now, I just see this handsome devil looking back at me. I don't feel like a monster anymore. My confidence is through the roof now. Without the lump on my face, I'm a lot more outgoing, confident person.
Would you like to feel it as well, Cal?
And I've made a lot of new friends. I've just been having a good time and enjoying myself.
Are you happy?
I'm definitely happy with it now, 100%. I'm very optimistic for my future as well now. I've had a job interview and I got the job and I'm looking forward to starting it. I feel amazing about myself. New person, new me, new mentality. I feel like I can do anything.